In this video, we're gonna attempt to make a game with Godot in 12 hours without any prior experience. Both me and Alex are Unity devs and our only experience is with Unity and C#. To make it harder, we're not allowed to read any documentation or watch any tutorial before starting this challenge. Okay, here we are. This looks pretty familiar. But let's be honest, guys. Godot is for little kids. Making this game is gonna be a breeze. How do I even make a cube? How can I change the font size?
How hard can it be to
work here? Okay, I might have underestimated Godot a little bit. I have absolutely no idea what the f*** I'm doing.
Let's start with the first thing you have to do for any game, and that's making the player move. I started by creating a node 2D as the main scene, and then adding another node 2D with a sprite for the player. We'll create a new script for the player, and of course we're gonna use C#, since that's the only thing I know. Oh, this is really cool. Godot also comes with a little code editor. However, IntelliSense doesn't seem to work with C#. Visual Studio it is then. Let's write some code to read the player input. This seems to work. Now let's make it move. Luckily, Godot has a great example for this. And as one of my university teachers used to say, programming is all about knowing what to copy. And I stand by that. So let's replace this code and there we go. This is working perfectly.
It was about time we came up with a real game idea. Since we have less than 11 hours left, we need to make sure our idea can be finished in the remaining time. This is easier said than done, as anyone who's ever been in a game jam knows what I'm talking about. Here's a short description of the idea we came up with, presented to you in our high-tech visualization software. You're this blue circle with a weapon, and you have to shoot other circles coming after you. Okay, this sounds like any other twin-stick shooter, but there's a catch. We let the match 3 mechanics so that enemies only die if you shoot at least 3 of the same color. On top of that, let's also make them explode in a cool chain effect when enemies of the same color die next to each other.
So we're basically making Vampire Survivors combined with freaking Zuma?
Something like that. Now that we have an idea and a moving player, we need a map. Let's find some assets to use for the game. I really like this particular set from Kenny Game Assets 3. We can use a tile set node to make the map. But how does this thing work?
5 minutes later.
Would you look at this masterpiece? After some trial and error, we discovered we can make the cell size smaller and also change the default background color. Finally, let's add this camera 2D to the player. And now we have our first playable demo. Except that it took like 3 hours to get here and you can't really do anything besides moving around.
Time to shoot some guns. We start off by adding a weapon and then position it so that it's easy to rotate around the player. So boom, new script, player weapon. Just add some math logic to calculate the rotation based on the mouse position. And there we go, we got this perfectly work... almost working weapon. Then I created an arrow and made it move. But how do I turn this arrow into a prefab? Just drag it into the project hierarchy? I guess I made the prefab? Now all I have to do is to spawn it from a script. Sounds easy enough. However, this soon turned out to be a nightmare. How do I spawn the arrow? Why is everyone talking about instantiating a scene? I just want to instantiate an object. What even is a scene? Apparently, scenes in Godot are very different from Unity scenes. In Godot, a scene is just a group of nodes. So even the player or a simple bullet is considered a scene. I guess that might have been helpful to know from the start, but hey, you learned something new every day. Okay, almost done. Clicking spawns an arrow, but it's parented to the weapon, which means it moves when the weapon moves. We just have to make sure its parent is the main scene. Alright, this should do it. What the f***? Okay, let's try this. At this point, we were starting to lose our sanity. Because absolutely nothing we tried worked. There was only one thing left to do. Delete everything and start over. So there I was, searching for a Godot tutorial in C#, which was way harder to find than I thought it would be. And I know you probably won't believe me, but I even opened the second page on Google search. Lo and behold, there it was, and it even has a GitHub page. This is some great code over here. Our code. And just like that, all those errors were now gone. Don't ask me what was wrong the first time. To this day, I have absolutely no idea. Great, we now have arrows spawned. Just give them a rotation and... we can rotate this by 90 degrees. I said 90 degrees. There we go. It finally works. This only took another 3 hours. Right now it's closer to a machine gun than a crossbow, but we can easily fix that by adding some reload time. And thanks to that tutorial from earlier, we even have collision detection for the arrows.
We have about half the time left, but I think we're done with the hard part. I still have no f***ing clue what I'm doing, but I think we might finish the game in time after all. Time to make some enemies. Let's add this red boy and make him follow you. Now let's add some more colored boys and make them get stunned when hit by an arrow. And now we with all the knowledge from before, it was time to take on the task of creating the enemy spawner. We defined the bounds of the main scene and also made it so that the enemies spawn in waves every few seconds. The game is starting to take shape, but it looks kinda bland. You know what it really needs? Some big ass explosions. And for that we have Godot's particle system. Let's give this a sphere shape, add some velocity, and boom, we already have an explosion. Just tweak a few more parameters and it looks awesome. Plus it only took like what, 10 minutes to make? After this, it was time to implement the match 3 mechanic we talked about in the beginning. All I had to do was count the amount of enemies stunned and then kill them all when you stun an enemy of a different color. Okay, now we have the main gimmick of the game, but this is not enough. You can't kill enemies fast enough this way and you get overwhelmed pretty quickly. So let's add the chain explosion we talked about earlier. The best way to do that would be to simply get all neighboring enemies and trigger an explosion on them if they are the right color. Let's see, I need a method similar to overlap sphere from Unity that will return all the colliders within a radius. I found this method called intersect shape, which I guess does what I'm looking for. What have I done? This thing is supposed to give me an array of objects, but I have no idea how to read the objects. Why is this a dictionary? How am I supposed to retrieve the items from this? After about 1 hour, we gave up trying to use this method. If anyone with more experience knows how intersect shape works, please let us know in the comments. Well, this is bad. We're running out of time. We ended up ditching this mechanic for a more simple one. We will simply kill all neighboring enemies at once, regardless of color. This was much easier to implement, as all I had to do was trigger the death method for every enemy based on his distance to the killed enemy. I know it's not the most efficient way, but it works properly, and the game is playable.
Two more hours left, let's add player lives so you can actually lose the game. And for that we need UI. Godot has this awesome feature of tiling sprites, which we can use to represent lives. Just drag this, add a short script, and would you look at that? We have a functioning life system. Let's add a scoring system, as well as a dev screen and a retry button. And now this game is finally complete.
No it's not, we're still missing an essential thing. We need sound effects.
Okay, let's find some sounds for hitting enemies and some free background music. Well, this sounds oddly familiar. We also need a cool explosion. This should do. We can simply trigger the explosion sound on death. Let's see what it sounds like. That's so loud. Okay, maybe playing 100 explosion sounds at once is not really the best idea.
Last minute bug fixes. Let's make a quick build and just like that the game is done. Here it is. Seems that it's starting to lag as more and more enemies pile up on screen. Oh boy, the lag is getting out of hand, but it's gonna be fine. Anyway, I think the gameplay turned out to be quite fun. You can try the game for yourself on itch.io, link is in the description. I challenge you all to try and beat my high score, or you can't do it. Overall, I found Godot to be quite easy to understand and user-friendly. I really like how fast everything loads and how small the project size is. The node system takes some getting used to, but once you understand how it works, it's very easy to use. So, is it possible to make a game in 12 hours using Godot for the first time? Yes, it is. However, do yourself a favor and read at least the introduction part of the documentation. If you liked this video and want to learn more about game development, be sure to also check out this other video where we delve deeper into the insights and experiences we gain throughout our game development journey.